situation or people so loud, and we'll be talking about development of our tourism potential here in the province of Sulu. We know that for a fact that Sulu has so much offer in terms of tourism. So this is precisely why there is this proposed tourism book. Although this tourism book is just for purposes of making people aware. We want to increase the horizon of awareness of our people, and of course we want greater participation from the community. Oh, because it is also the community that will benefit. But then, unlike other areas, we cannot just adopt tourism code, considering that ours is a more unique situation in Sulu, because our culture is far different from the rest, since our culture is also intertwined with religious practices. So there are so many do's and don'ts in here in the province or among our people. Yeah, and another natin talagang may awareness ng ating mga tao. And as well as, of course, we're also very particular about our environment. So it does not mean that if we develop our tourism potential here in the province of Sulu, we can just invite and bring in investors to our province. Of course, we want investors, but investors must be, of course, regulated. So, as I say, when an outsider owns properties, this become private properties of people from the outside. More often than that, they do whatever they want in the property. So, as much as possible, I do not want people from the outside to buy any part of our province. If ever, dapat, nauso, pangsaso, tayo, whether Christian, Muslim, Chinese, or what, basta pangsaso. So, yan lang, because we have a very small province here, o yung lang ang province provincia natin, this is our only province, so we have to treasure it, protect it, and preserve it. So, kaya, kailangan, meron talaga ang awareness. Of course, this is within the competence of the provincial government, or particularly the office of the governor. There's really no need to come up with a tourism code, for it is already within the authority of the office of the governor. But then for purposes now, para aware, di tayo, si naming kahalan, si naming ulang tayo, why does we come up with a code, some kind of a parang pag-training, yamang tayo, as well as said, parameters ang mga campaigning pasal si code, pasal si mga practices. Because recent past, may mga from the outside, of course, I'm aware about practices here, about religious practices, about our culture. So, Narisila, at times, the attire, they come with mga pagpahing sila, very short shorts or bikini at our tubis at our patiso na yung mga yan para tao na on culture tayo, on my demand tayo kinamin na such one on my demand yan, on God na one amin tayo sa mga pagpahing pangalawa amin mga makinom. Ipapin beses. Of course, I'm very glad that this is already river, medyo, medyo regulated na po, hindi na lang. Including security sector, hindi pwede mapaninom sa public places. Pulis, sundalo, hindi pwede. Lalo-lalo na yung civilian. So, yan ang namin natin because we have to respect natin ang religious practices, ang kultura, and of course, respect yung mga constituents natin dito because families din ang pagpasyal, not only individuals, but families. Kaya kailangan natin mayroon mga ano na magkagatayin sa atin on how we do it. Now, on tourism development, of course, there are so many things that are required for the development of what tourism. You know, tourism project and you look for, do you have health centers? Do you have connectivity? Do you have mga toilet or water supply? So, sanitation. Yan ang mga hinahanap. So, we really do not have to be like the rest. So, let us learn from the mistakes of others. Remember, we call it mistakes. Like, Boracay. Way back, I went to Boracay.
Guidelines on tourism.